What's up, everyone, and welcome to Ola Learns Shit. It's basically me sitting down on my chair, learning a cool song. How about that? Today I'm gonna learn somewhat of a classic of Fire and the Void by Behemoth from the album Evangelion. Evangelion, Ola, Evangelion. No, Evangelion, okay? This is probably my favorite song of Behemoth, and no one requested it. I just wanted to learn it because I always thought it was a kick-ass song. And it has a lot of tremolo parts in it, and I need to practice my tremolo, so that's what's gonna happen today. I have this V2.6 Solar baritone, it's a 27 inch scale length. The song itself is in C sharp standard, so... it's chunky, right? And we're just gonna head straight into it. Obviously, I've heard this song before. I haven't attempted to play it before, but we're gonna learn it today. So, starting from the top. Dude, hello. Kick ass. What is wrong with you if you're not headbanging to this? Just saying. Let's just start with that first riff, man. What is that? Oh shit. Shit, okay. That's the second guitar. Okay. No. Fuck, man. Enzo Drippin Fancy Cool. Yeah. That's not easy. I think this is gonna be a challenge for my right hand, let's just say that. But what's the main riff? That was the second guitar right there, but what's the main riff? The notes are really easy to find, it's just that you need to tremolo pick a lot. Oh. Oh, okay, let's just continue. The problem is switching from tremolo to that first chord. Because I'm using a completely different technique for when I'm doing tremolo picking from my standard picking, which is... this is me picking like a... oh, everyday Ola. But when I tremolo pick... you can see that I'm anchoring my hand and just going full force. So it's completely different from my other picking technique, so switching between the two, that's kind of challenging. That's why we're practicing this. I'm gonna figure this out. Fuck yeah. Okay. Well, it's not in major at least, so... easy. Okay. Okay. It's nice to have this part which is very, very, you know, it's a place to rest. For the tremolo. Okay. Okay. So it's not full on tremolo there, it's basically like a group of four. Okay. Okay. Oh shit, what was that? I'm just gonna say, it's a lot easier, because I've heard this song so many times, it's just a lot easier for me to catch on to these riffs. If you compare it to a song you never heard, I mean, that you need to get used to listening to that song in your head first. But since I've heard this song so many times, it's very easy for me to relate where to play all of it. And I mean, the chords themselves are not challenging, it's just the picking part that's a little bit... Something like that, right? Yeah. Back to the verse. Oh, the kick drums are different here, listen. So a little bit easier than in the beginning. What is that? What? Okay. Easy. Another part. Oh man, man, man. Da-na. Okay. But the guitar strings sound a little bit more... They're probably playing it up here and not down there where I was playing it. Okay. What is happening? Okay. Something like that. I'm not completely sure. Okay, solo. Okay. What? Is that it? But faster, so it's maybe... I think that's it. Win it! Win it! Okay. Well, that was easy. Oh my god, okay. Okay, I got this, easy. It's just a little, small little nuances and feel things that a little... If you're not used to hearing the solo, it can be a little bit tricky, okay? But it's fairly straightforward solo. Close enough, baby! Okay, I think I have most of it down. Let's just go from the top. Let's go! Almost. Sorry. What was that? 36 minutes, including playing the song in its entirety. Was it perfect? Of course, it was note for note perfect, that one. No, it was pretty close for 35 minutes worth of learning this song. It's not too bad. It's actually not that complicated of a song. The challenge right here is switching between the tremolo and the... that is hard for me. And keeping the control of that tremolo is also really hard. So that's something I definitely need to practice on. Also, that the coolest riff in the song, it's only played once in the song. I wish there was more of that riff, you know, the... I mean, that's such a bang of a riff right there, but it only appears once in the song. That was fun. I finally know the song now. I always wanted to learn this song, but I never did. But I know it now, and it's kick-ass. This video is probably gonna get demonetized, but you can help me out by subscribing to my channel and like this video and whatnot. I have some merch and shit you can buy down in the description of this video. And maybe, hopefully, you enjoyed this little video right there and see me struggle a little bit. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Goodbye.